Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. If you're working for a large organization, you probably have lots of reports published out, and you're probably using some type of template that's been implemented as part of your governance process when you're designing your reports. And you have a specific layout, a specific background. It's probably a logo that you use. And let's say you change your company logo and you need to go and bulk change all the reports to use the new logo. Well, you will probably open each report one at a time, edit, delete the old image, insert the new image. I'm not lazy and just efficient, and that's not something I want to do. Fortunately, Ruru Mana, who works for the Fabric team at Microsoft, showed me a way using SymPy and a few other libraries and APIs how you can do this in bulk. So you know how we like to do? Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So you can see we have this report, and we have a really strict policy at our company about how we design our reports. We have our logo in the top left corner, a title, and a visual on each report page. And so if you look at report two, same thing, logo, a slicer, a visual, and a title, same thing with report three. And what I want to do is I want to change that Dataverse logo to the Power BI logo. Edit, change, edit, change, edit, change. Not efficient. So let's go over to the notebook. The first thing we do is we don't need to install SymPy anymore. We just import some modules. You can see the SymPy modules, pandas, and some other modules that we need. And then we initiate the Fabric client. And then the next code block and the next cell, what we want to do is find the path that we want to replace. And so what's done in the code is we get the items from the workspace, filter them down the report, and we're just getting the first one because the way it iterate through the list of them is the index is zero based. And so that's just the first one. Then there's an API call that actually gets the report definition, and then we parse it out and you can return it. So let's run this. And you can see, because it's pretty standard, if I look at the first report that was published to the workspace, we have a theme that we're using, our company logo, and put the Guy in the Cube logo at the bottom. And then this is actually the PBIR, the definition and report JSON. Okay. If I switch this to the second report, because our company is pretty standard, you'll see the exact same thing. And then if I change this to number two, you'll see the exact same thing. And what we want to do is I want to change this company logo, because not only do we follow a standard with how we design the reports, we also follow a standard with how we name the images that we include in our reports. This is something you'll have to consider if you want to use something like this. Something else I want to show you, if you check the box for PBIR, you'll be able to actually see this. I save report one as a project, and if I go into report one.report and I go to static resources, in the registered resources, you can see company logo 942. And the original name of the image was company logo, but when I inserted it into the report, it added these additional numbers, probably to make it unique. Unfortunately, when you make the project files, you can't publish it yet. You need to use version control like Azure DevOps or Git. You would save it there and then integrate Git into your workspace. Then you can publish them that way. It's not supported right now, but I'm sure it's coming. And now what I want to do is I say I want to change this from Dataverse. So let me comment that out to Power BI. So I'm going to run this. It takes that image, base encodes it. I'm telling it what part I want to replace, and I got that from this. I'm just copying these numbers from my static registered resources. And then when I run this, it's going to iterate through all my reports in that workspace and update the logo. And so all I'm doing is getting the list of the items, filtering it down, making a call, an API call to get the definition. And then you can see right here where I'm actually assigning my new base encoded image to that. And then I make another API call to update that definition. So I'm going to go ahead and run this, and it's going to loop through all my reports. And what you'll see is processing one, change image, processing two, change another image, processing three, change image four. What is this? What is this report ID? I'm not sure. We'll come back to that, but let's take a look at my report. So if I go to report one, Power BI logo, report two, Power BI logo, and report three, Power BI logo. But what is this other report? So let's take a look at this ID, 61D. Let's go to my workspace, the chaos that is Adam. Let's click this. 61D, that's Adam. So that's the report ID that we're using by SymPy to make this change. I don't know what that is, but I'll have to talk to Adam about something he did. But the point about this is you gotta be careful, because when you start putting new reports that don't follow the standard, it won't update those images because it just doesn't know. And you'll have to walk through this process just for that specific report. If you want to do something like that, you can use the ordinal base index. In this case, I know this would be number three that was uploaded. So I can actually go here and change the index from two, because I know two was the last one that I uploaded. So we choose three. Adam has some image there. It's not the right one, but if I wanted to replace it, I can follow the same steps and get that updated. All right, what do you think? It's a lot, but it will help you in the long run to make, you know, your report development and changes to specific items in your report much more efficient. All right, if you have any questions, comments, want to learn more about this, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to know more about Fabric and all the workloads inside of Fabric, like Power BI, lake houses, data engineering, data warehouses, it's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.